I'm Mike Bourque. I'm the Vice President of Information Technology here at Boston College. The Computer Center here in St. Clements is the main information technology processing hub for the university. It contains 800-plus servers and storage facilities. All the central services for computing, including things such as the website, email, backup and recovery, the course registration and course management systems. We moved the data center here to St. Clements from its prior location in the O'Neill Library on Columbus Day weekend 2006. This required the cooperation of the university to schedule downtime over a single weekend. The entire project, working with facilities, the architect, and the construction team, took about a year and a half. We lay out the equipment in predefined spaces which constitute a rack, and within a rack we have up to 42 storage spaces where we can fit computers and other equipment. We power each rack from multiple locations to ensure reliability. The main networking cables which connect the three campuses, the Brighton campus, the Chestnut Hill campus, and the Newton campus, all come together here at St. Clements Hall. Those cables come into the main data center, fan out in our own network here within the data center. The network is below the floor, goes throughout the floor up to each and every rack. This rack stores all the data related to our email infrastructure here at Boston College. Every day we receive somewhere in the neighborhood of 300,000 to 500,000 emails. Approximately 70 or 80% of those emails are nothing but spam. These racks are servers used by the biology department to do high performance computing. It's consuming a lot of electricity and generating a lot of heat. So we've had to add a little extra cooling in this area. In many instances, we use something called a blade center. The blade center allows us to have up to 14 different computer servers sharing two highly efficient power supplies. Each blade within the blade center represents a unique physical server. But even within these servers, we use the concept of virtualization. I like to equate virtualization in terms of servers to carpooling, whereby every individual doesn't need their own car to get to the destination. Same thing's true with computers. Everybody doesn't need their own physical computer to get their computational tasks done. We can put logical images on one physical server and share that physical server. This unit is a robotic tape silo. We use this for backing up all the centralized data in this computer center. It's got a database where it knows what tapes where, but then it verifies it with the barcode. You'll notice on the floor of the computer center, we've already marked out our potential expansion spots for additional racks. But we're constantly replacing equipment and shrinking the footprint to try to avoid any further expansion. To the naked eye, the computer center doesn't look a lot different than it did 3.5 years ago when we moved in, yet the capacity is more than doubled. The space itself here in the computer center is essentially what was a chapel originally. The data center has 16 beautiful stained glass windows. St. Isidore of Seville is known as the patron saint of computers and of the internet. About 1,500 years ago, he tried to document universal knowledge, all knowledge of his day. So we think it's quite appropriate that St. Isidore has a prominent spot overlooking the data center.